everyone. Welcome to our channel, Biology for All. In this video, I'm going to talk about the excretory products. Let us first begin with what are excretory products. These are metabolic wastes. Metabolic wastes are produced due to the metabolic activity that takes place in the cells of our body. Metabolic activities or metabolism includes anabolism and catabolism. Catabolism is breakdown of substances, whereas anabolism is when complex substances are made from simple ones. So these mainly result in producing the nitrogenous waste. Apart from this, carbon dioxide and water are also called metabolic waste. So how are these nitrogenous waste formed? These are basically formed in two ways: breaking down body's own proteins and nucleic acids, or breaking down the excess of amino acids that has been consumed by the body. The process of breaking down body's own proteins is called endogenous, and the other process is called exogenous. Both the processes results in production of nitrogenous waste. These nitrogenous waste can be of different types in different organisms. They're mainly of three types: ammonia, urea, and uric acid. Other than this, they can also be in the form of amino acids. They can also be formed in the form of trimethylamine, creatinine, allantoin, and also sometimes in the form of ornithic acid and guanine. Now, why do we need to break down the amino acids? We know that amino acids are the building blocks for proteins. So here we are talking of breaking down the excess of amino acids. So why do we need to break it down? We know that body can store carbohydrates and fats. That is, glucose is converted to glycogen and stored, and excess fats are also stored in our body. But it is not possible to store amino acids. Hence, the excess of amino acids has to be broken down and eliminated. This process is called as deamination, which removes the NH2 group from the amino acids. That results in an organic acid that remains after the removal of the NH2 group. This organic acid is used for energy production, and also the remaining ones is converted to either carbohydrate or fat and is stored. So this is the way by which the nitrogenous wastes are formed in our body.